you kind of get used to the same people always around. Are there any players that kind of stick out that have been responsive, either good or bad, hopefully good, but that have been responsive to some of your warm-up mixes or just kind of your style or requested specific tracks, things like that? You're kind of smiling there. You guys.
Yeah, I'm laughing because with the Mystics, they're very responsive, and the first player that comes to mind is Natasha Cloud.
You ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
Yeah. I think if you ever see
I love Cloud.
If you ever see highlights of Natasha dancing,
you got a good dancing team, actually.
Yo, they love to dance. They're into it. It's cool to see other teams when they come in, they're into it, you know, as well. I was told by a game director from the Mystics that he got a lot of great feedback from visiting teams, like y'all DJ is really good. But definitely Natasha Cloud comes to mind.
Yeah,
you know, before games I started getting lists. One of the ball girls would bring me the team's request of what they want to hear.
Oh, nice.
Good. When they hit the court and warm it up, and that became so cool. One game, they was like extra ratchet with it. They was like, yeah, we want to hear Hot Girl Summer by Megan Thee Stallion. We want to hear that Itty Bitty Piggy, Nicki Minaj. I'm like, oh, this is how y'all feel today.
I love the WNBA player, man. They don't care.
Okay, Ivory. Wow. Oh my goodness. You gotta be lighthearted, right?
Yeah. Little kid at play.
I love it. Oh, how do they know that? Old school, bringing it back. Bring it back to the old school, I love it.
Oh my goodness.
The coaches are having a laugh as well, which is fun. Hey!
Wow. It's like that's what gets me going. You know, that's what gets me going. I know Joe has some experience with that. He's had some of the most, you know, the
first game. My first game I played, it was Asia Wilson. She was jamming out, and they're on the headset like they're jamming out over there, and I was like, okay, good. Let's keep it going. City Girls, man. City Girls was the key last season.
That was a summer play.
Liz came in, and she really turns up. She's definitely my favorite for warm-ups. I'll look at her like, I'm doing well, right? She's jamming, and yeah, it's going well.
Has she ever DJed with you yet?
No, I'm looking forward to it, but not yet.
You got to make that happen. We do a Liz Kimbish DJ cam that's kind of fun, but we got to bring that to the next level this year.
Man. Like I definitely missed the WNBA. I feel like I feel like I did have a lot more reign. Obviously, Sky is a huge music head. You know, we had great times doing. You know, we do camps and we do all the dances. There was the summer of the dances, all of the what's his name, the whipping and all that. That whole era. You know what I mean? It's like that whole time. But the nay-naying and whatever. But you can't do it like me. All of that stuff. You know, we had a good run doing those kind of things. In the league, I'm notorious for being the DJ that takes care of both teams. I mean, I know it's probably not the most popular opinion, but I feel as though I think I just need to. So, I mean, in terms of us, like, we have obviously like an extremely international team. JJ, I started playing a lot of like reggaeton, you know, Latin music for JJ for his warm-ups. And obviously, like, as much as you guys know, like, you know your warm-up schedule. So, you know, at this point in our arena, you could tell who's warming up by what's playing for the most part. And obviously that continued with Luca. We went through a really big Bad Bunny craze like earlier last season. That, and then, you know, I've also, given some spins, you know, for like Dame and Vic Oladipo and, you know, some of the guys who make music, and, you know, and they'll tell me things like, oh man, like, you know, this and the third. I mean, Steph was really cool about giving me some Slovenian music, because I guess they have a huge Slovenian population in Cleveland. So Steph Loss, shout out to him, slid a little record. He was like, here, try this. And when I did it, Boban and Luca did their little, you know, their little dancing line thing. It's just created some really great viral moments. But yeah.
You know. I have kind of a funny story on some negative feedback I received one time. We were doing some consulting with the Sacramento Kings, and I was working with Dan Spackman, DJ down there. You know, we're just kind of like, we're in there to help them, you know, amplify their fan experience and kind of just refresh it a little bit. You know, we're friends with all the guys that are working down there. And, you know, this is in DeMarcus Cousins' years, and, like, he was – oh man! So, you know, Dan's been a DJ there forever. He's still a good friend of mine. Awesome dude. But like, for this, it's opening day, and so, you know, I'm DJing it just so he can see, you know, another way to do it, because he always worked off one computer. I wanted to show him how I was working off two, just to expand, you know, some possibilities out there. So I'm doing opening night, and DeMarcus Cousins had sent over some music that he wanted for when the players run out for formal warm-ups, right? Like the time. It's like you're meeting your, you know, whatever year it was, 2017 Sacramento Kings, like for the first time when they come out for formal warm-ups. And he wanted No Type by Ray Schremer. And I'm like, I like that song. Like, I'm a Ray Schremer fan, but I'm like, that song has no energy. Like, that's not the time to hit that song. That's just not it. I'm a hired consultant to make sure the fan experience is different and better. So I'm like, nah, we're not doing that. I'm not playing that. There's no way. I don't care. They're like, oh, DeMarcus is gonna be pissed, man. Like, he'll be mad. And I'm like, there's no way he's gonna leave. Like, it's opening night. That's just not, like, there's no way he cares that much, right? I was wrong. I was totally wrong. So they come out for warm-ups, and like I didn't do anything like crazy at the time. It was like We Them Boys was fairly new. It just had more energy. It fit the moment better. Like, we had been building this whole pregame to try to, you know, amplify it and change it. I'm like, there's no way I'm coming out to No Type. Like, that has no beat. It's like there's no way. So I come out to We Them Boys, which is not a bad pick at the time. DeMarcus Cousins does not, he runs out. He's like the first guy in the line. He runs out, does not take a layup, runs directly to the director's table, right at center court. Mo Brazelton, longtime director, still directing games.
Oh, man.
Has his headset on. I can hear what's happening. And Pat Walker's down there, too. And they're at the table. DeMarcus Cousins comes right up to him. No layups, not even considering the layup line. Runs right up to him, says, Mo! Play my shit, Mo. Play my shit, Mo. Quit with me, Mo. And I can hear all this in the headset. I'm like, oh shit. Like, oh, you know, I'm like, oh my God. I'm a consultant coming in here. Like, okay, I'm doing what I think is right. You know, and he's saying this on the headset. You know, I was like, all right, I'll play your shit, Mo. I'll play your shit. And so I switched it, played No Type. Just like, it's like, damn. It's like that out here, man. I wasn't ready for that.
I wasn't the end of it.
I wasn't ready. I was not ready. I was, because I was like, there's no way he has control over stuff like that. I just thought that was crazy. And then it was just like, yeah, he has control. Full circle, you know, fast forward to, that was a long time. It was like 2015. 2017 NBA Africa game. I'm DJing that. And DeMarcus is out there, Victor Oladipo, and you know, I ended up redeeming myself. You know, I ended up stopping the layup line and turning it into a dance circle. It was like Bodak Yellow was peaking at that time. And I had like a nice little mix into that, and it, like, Victor Oladipo and DeMarcus stopped layup line and just did a dance circle. So I feel like I came full circle with DeMarcus.
Redeemed yourself.
Yeah.
Nice.
I got Steph Curry to dance this year. That was quite something.
Nice. Like, I love it when I see, like, responsive players. I don't care if it's like my team or the other team. I just like seeing, like, okay, people got a pulse. People are picking up what I'm putting down. That's one of my favorite things to do, honestly.